video, we are going to learn about basics of electric power and electrical energy. But before starting with this video, I strongly recommend you to watch the previous videos of this series. You'll get link for all the videos down in the description. If you have already done with the previous videos, then let's move on. We know that when we apply voltage to a circuit, and by circuit I mean a closed path, electrons starts flowing through that circuit. Now, definitely when these electrons are flowing through this circuit, some work is being done to move electrons. This work done in moving electrons in unit time is what we call as electric power. We can also relate this with weightlifters. They have to lift the weight against the pull of gravity. If the weight is very heavy or if they have to lift it very high, the amount of work done is also has to be very high. And this work done is called as power. In similar way, when we apply voltage to a circuit, electrons will start flowing against the opposition offered by resistance. Now definitely, when these electrons are flowing through this circuit, some work is being done to move electrons. And this work done in moving electron in unit time is what we call as electric power. We can define power as, power is a measure of how much work can be performed in a given amount of time. Simple, let's hear it again. Power is a measure of how much work can be performed in a given amount of time. Now let's focus on the figure shown. When we apply voltage V across the circuit, current I will start flowing against the opposition offered by the resistance R. Now, in the concept of current video, we saw that current is a charge flowing per second, that is, current will equal to Q by T. We can further write this equation as Q is equals to I multiplied by T. We have also seen that voltage is equals to work by charge. So further we will write this equation as work is equals to V multiplied by Q. Now let's put the value of Q in this equation. So it will be work is equals to voltage multiplied by current into time. Now what is power? Power is a measure of how much work can be performed in a given amount of time. So we can write as power is equals to work divided by time. Let's put the equation of work in this equation. So power will equal to voltage multiplied by current into time and divided by time. So this time and time will get cancelled and we will remain with power is equals to voltage multiplied by current, joules per second or watts. Further, as per Ohm's law, voltage is equals to I into R and current is equals to voltage divided by R. So if we put these values in the equation of power, we will also get power equals to I square R and power is equals to V square by R. All the equations of power just we have seen just now can be used to calculate the power of DC circuit depending upon the parameters you have. One thing here we should remember that power depends upon both, that is voltage and current. In an open circuit where current flowing through circuit is zero, power will also be zero no matter how great voltage is. In similar way, in case of short circuit, voltage is zero and hence power will also be zero no matter how great current is. Now let's learn about unit of electric power. Unit of electric power is joules per second or watts, what is most commonly used. Unit of power named as watts after the Scottish inventor James Watt because of his contribution in steam engines and development of concept of horsepower. We can say power of circuit is 1 watt if we apply voltage of 1 volt across the circuit and current of 1 ampere flows through it. If we want power in watt, then voltage should be in volts and current should be in ampere. We also have some bigger units for power like 1 kilowatt which is equals to 1000 watts or 1 megawatt which is equal to 10 raised to the power 6 watts. We can also measure power in horsepower and 1 horsepower is equals to 745.7 watts. Now as you can see in the figure, this is a picture of a DC fan. On the fan it is mentioned voltage as 12 volt and current as 0.8 ampere. Now, by using this data, we will calculate power required by this fan. So, as we have seen, power is equals to voltage multiplied by current. So, power is equals to 12 into 0.18, which will give us 2.16 watts. So, this indicates 2.16 watts of power will be consumed by this fan. Now, let's learn about electrical energy. Total amount of work done in an electric circuit is called as electric power. So, simply what we have to do, we have to multiply electrical power into time and we will get electrical energy. Electrical energy will be equal to V into T or I square R into T or V square R into T. You can use any of this formula to calculate electrical energy. Unit of electrical energy depends upon the unit of power and time. For example, if power is in watts and time is in second, then the unit of electrical energy would be watts per second. If power is in watts and time is in hours, then the unit of electrical energy would be watts per hour. If power is in kilowatts and the time is in hours, then the unit of electrical energy would be kilowatt per hour, or kWh in short. kWh is also used for calculating the monthly charges of electricity. Generally, in India, on your electricity bill, you will find a column for total unit consumed. And one unit is equals to 1 kWh of electrical energy. So if your bill says 10 units consumed, then it means you have consumed 10 kilowatt per hour of electrical energy. Okay, so that's it. I hope you understood what is electrical power and energy. That's all for this video, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.